Western Michigan comes to Muncie just 1-12, but the Broncos are 1-1 and tied with Ball State in the Mid-American Conference Western Division. The Cardinals won on the road at Eastern Michigan last Saturday after dropping the conference opener to Ohio. Head coach Tim Buckley knows to be competitive in the MAC, you have to defend your home court. Ball State battles Western Michigan next on WCRH Sports. On the next timeout. T. Smith still looking to get on track. Patrick Jackson wants three, and he's got it. It rolled around the rim. Patrick Jackson from downtown. This is Khan at the top of the key. Ball State still in the man-to-man.
Haven't seen the Cardinals play too much zone all this year.
Unlike the women that play zone every time out.
Reynolds is back into the ball game.
Here's Slater, no good. Western cooling down a little bit, but not much. T. Smith gets away for a breakaway dunk, and he's fouled. Send T to the line.
Smith fortunate he wasn't whistled. Looked like he was on the rim for a little while. Let's take a look at that again if we can. Nice pass all the way ahead, flinched to Smith. There you see he's hit from behind by Slater. Doesn't prevent him from throwing it down.
20-second timeout taken by Western, and boy does Muncie love their dunks. Johnny Worthen Arena erupted with that last one by T. Smith.
So the Cardinals were down 11 early with this Smith free throw, a chance to cut the lead to three.
Powell has 10 for Western Michigan. Ball State is led by Lonnie Jones with 6 points. T. Smith has 4, and he'll go to the line to try to add some more of that.
It was 21-12 following the media timeout at the 12-minute mark. Ball State has since been on a 7-2 run.
T. Smith will be at the line. All right, now we're going to check in with Justin Herber. He's roaming the sidelines.
Yeah, that's right, fellas. This has not been a friendly place for Western Michigan. They haven't won a game here since 1988, which means they've never won in this building. Back to you guys.
Thanks a lot, Justin. I'm sure that's a stat that the Western Michigan Broncos want to erase today.
Of course, that means they won in the old Irving Gym, or the Irving Gym.
Cedric Moody comes out of the rebound, in and out. Josh Murray finds it. And another dunk by Lonnie Jones.
I don't think Murray realized how open he was when he got that rebound. He could have went up with it, did a head fake, but Jones was there to clean house.
So Ball State is back in this one, trailing by 2 points. Another looking open three for Western. Reynolds misses that, and T comes off with a rebound.
Jones and T collided for the rebound. Lonnie wanted that one too.
That's Theron's second board of the game. Patrick calls the play up top. Here's Moody on the baseline. Good pass to T. He lays it up. No.
Before the shot.
He's called for traveling.
Couldn't quite see from our view what was going on down there. Looked like T may have shuffled his feet if he wasn't fouled. Crowd voicing their displeasure, but the Cardinals have made a nice little run. Cut the lead down to two.
23-21, as you see on the WCRH scoreboard. Connell check back again on the next dead ball for Western. Good looking shot by Reggie Berry. 6'4 freshman out of Houston, Texas.
Western still shooting above the 60% mark.
And this is what Ball State has to do. They got to get it down to the big fella because he's soaring over everyone down low. The whistle down low. Lonnie Jones is called for a personal. It's his first, team's third foul.
One of the keys we talked about for Western to be successful, they needed to have play strong transition defense and avoid easy baskets. So far, just that one basket really in a fast break form, the T. Smith dunk and the foul.
Ball State trails by four, 8 minutes to play here in the first half.
Billy Lynch will come back in at the next whistle.
Just joining us, Western came out on fire. They hit their first 4 3-point attempts and had an 11-point lead. Here's Taylor Breaux off the back of the rim, and T comes off with another rebound.
Smith caught a break there. He let Breaux root away a spot down there.
Cedric on the baseline, tries to draw contact. Patrick wants another three. Bricks it off the back rim.
Nice job by Murray to pull things back out.
Another whistle down low. They're going to get Barry for a foul. So from here on out, Ball State's in the bonus.
Let's see if Lonnie can take some confidence. The first two free throws he knocked down, let's see if he can carry that momentum into this shot. We talked about Jones struggling at the line this season, under 40%.
Lonnie's two for two today, leads Ball State with 8 points. It's a good look at the big fella. Free throw is no good. Kahn comes off with it for Western. Western will push. Another shot.
Not a smart foul by Murray. That'll be worth three shots. Two shots for Powell. Okay, they're going to say he was on the line. Murray went down to double-team the post. A quick kick out to Powell, and Josh couldn't do anything but foul him on the jump shot.
Powell's been the story so far for Western. He has 10 points. Comes into the game averaging 11, so he's almost hit that already.
Powell's numbers have been on the rise since the conference season began.
He's a 72% free throw shooter as he sinks the first. But shooting 87% in conference play.
A season ago, Ball State won here in Muncie against Western, 80-60. T. Smith led all scorers with 21 points to go along with 9 rebounds. And Lonnie was a force as well. Lonnie Jones, 13 rebounds, also put in 11 points.
Powell hits the second, and we got a timeout on the floor. With 17-17 to play in the first half, Ball State trails by 6. This is Ball State men's basketball on WCRH.
Think about your needs.
I need to be inspired. I need personal attention from professors who care.
I need a kick in the...
University, everything you need.
Ball State Sports Online. Schedule, results, headlines, features, statistics, game notes, team pages, video and audio clip, biography, email, Ball State links, daily updates. Your only online source for all the latest in Ball State sports. www.bsu.edu/sports.
Well, Western still shooting the ball well, 58%. They have cooled down a little bit. At one point, they were 8 of 12, now 10 of 17 from the field. Ball State, 9 of 21 and 1 of 4 from behind the three-point line.
We're going to throw it over to Justin Herbert. Justin?
You know, coming into this game, Western Michigan had the lowest field goal percentage in the MAC coming in, but you'd never be able to tell it by that barrage of three-pointers they put on us. But what Ball State needs to take advantage of is the fact that Western gives up the worst field goal percentage. So that's one thing Ball State needs to take advantage of, getting open shots.
The Broncos giving up 77 points a game.
Thanks a lot, Justin. Ball State trails by 6 with 7 minutes to play.
Moody's hasn't been able to skirt open from the outside.
Good pass by Billy Lynch down low to Murray. It's kicked around. Differentiate on calls. And Ball State will have it down low. Good look by Billy Lynch to find Josh Murray.
Western switched up defenses following the break. Broncos went into the 2-3, and it looks like they'll stay in it right here.
Bad pass by Patrick Jackson. Sails over Billy Lynch's head, and Western will have it back. It's Ball State's seventh turnover already, Todd.
You get a feeling the Cardinals just looking to explode, looking for some room offensively. They've really been quiet, only the 9 of 21 we talked about, 43%.
This is Powell again. He's firing today, and he airballs it. Rebound by Western. 18 seconds on the shot clock. Collum thought about it, but Barry will take it. No good, and Lonnie comes off with a rebound.
After hitting five of their first seven, two bad misses right there. Barry and Collum well off the mark.
Cedric is well covered in the corner. Bad pass from Cedric. That's the team's eighth turnover. Ball State's starting to fluster a little bit.
That's the fifth steal for Western. They lead the Mid-American Conference with steals per game coming in at eight.
Jones is going to get whistled down low. It'll be his second foul, team's fifth.
Holding foul on Ball State's 45. Lonnie Jones is his second. And the team's
Western
fifth.
Michigan, four turnovers today. Ball State, an electrifying eight. Coach Buckley cannot be happy with the way his team's taking care of the ball.
Cardinals dominating on the board, 16-7. Western's been out-rebounded in every single game. We said that a couple times throughout the show.
T. Smith checks back in for the Cardinals. Here's Cullum for three. Western's still in love with a three-point shot. They've cooled off. They're now 5 of 11 from downtown. T. Smith on a drive is fouled, so he'll go to the line.
11 of the 20 shots the Broncos have taken have been from behind the three-point line, so they've taken more than half of their shots from beyond the arc. Kind of reminds you of the Anderson team we saw that just frustrated Ball State perimeter defense, knocking down three-pointer after three-pointer.
Anderson came into Worthen Arena, absolutely on fire, and this was the biggest game that they played all year. So they were going to bring their A game to the table. T. Smith will be at the line for 1-1. He's a 67% free throw shooter on the year. T. comes into the game averaging 16.6 points per game and 9 rebounds, nearly 10 rebounds per contest. Theron Smith was, of course, the MAC Freshman of the Year last year.
Reynolds back on the floor for Western. He's been quiet.
There's Coach Buckley in his first season at Ball State University. T misses the first one.
Getting back to Reynolds. He picked up two quick fouls, sat down for a minute, back on the floor for a short time. Coach McCullum took him out. Now he's back in, 5 minutes remaining in the first half.
This is Khan up top. Western hangs on to a lead as we got a whistle down low, 27-21. 5:25 to play in the first half. That foul's on Theron Smith, his first. Team six, so the next foul by Ball State. Western will be shooting.
One of the reasons that Western's thrown up so many long bombs is the distinct size advantage the Cardinals have. Western without a player over 6'7", Ball State having three in at one time.
And now Western finds himself cooling down from behind the three-point arc. Theron will bring it up himself. Cedric in the corner, got it.
Moody, one of the best pure shooters on this team, him and Rob Robbins, they get open from behind the three-point line. Moody's 12th three of the year. He's 12 for 22 now.
With that bomb, he cuts the lead in half. Ball State trails by three. Here's Powell. Reynolds with a nice fake, goes up for a shot. No good. Rebound tapped away, and Western will have a fresh clock.
Reynolds unable to get that bucket to fall. That's one of the things he has, is a good mid-range game.
Collum misses another three, and Western comes off with a rebound. Nice lay-in by Carter over the outstretched arms of Lonnie Jones.
Carter challenged Jones. Ball State can't afford to give three or four chances on the defensive rebounding end.
Western pushes the lead back to five. Cedric wants another three. Got it again.
Moody's never been afraid to shoot. You could tell looking at him right there when he was calling for the ball, it was going up. Two straight possessions, two straight threes for Cedric Moody.
Collum on the other end is fouled, so he'll go to the line for two. Billy Lynch will be called with it.
Cedric Moody with back-to-back three-pointers. Cuts the lead to two for Western Michigan. Todd, I've been impressed with the Broncos so far. We've been able to see, this is the third time we've seen them this year. We saw them play at the Indiana Classic. They really didn't play that well. You could tell they were trying to mesh together. As we see, Cedric hit another bomb.
Western did play well in that consolation game, hanging with Texas Tech, who I thought was an okay ball club. The Cardinals handled them pretty easily, but still Texas Tech at times showed they were going to be competitive. Western losing by single digits, so they were in that ball game throughout. But definitely a different look we're seeing now than what we've seen. Well, of course, that was early December.
Cullum hits the first one. And the second. 31-27, 4 minutes even to play.
See if they can find the hot hand and keep Moody shooting from outside.
Cedric had his hand up. Good ball movement by Ball State. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Cedric thought about the three, pulls it back out. Down to T. Smith. He misses the layup. Murray taps it around and he's fouled. So Josh Murray will go to the line for two.
One of the things somebody like Moody hitting a couple shots does is it forces the defense to overplay on him to take away that jump shot. Cedric always been able to create. Let's see if he can drive the lane and make some dump offs to Smith and Murray.
Weston's coach Robert McCallum. McCollum. Murray at the line for two. 39% free throw shooter. Not a very nice looking one there. Cedric comes off with the ball and he'll get the ball back for Ball State.
Nice job to pull it out.
3:24 in the first half, Ball State trails by four. Billy Lynch with a quick pass to Patrick.
Quick ball rotation by Ball State, unable to get a shot off though, shot clock approaching 10.
Jackson with a pass over to Lynch for three. He's got it. Billy can do that when he's wide open, Todd.
He doesn't. His fifth three-pointer on the season in 13 attempts. He doesn't take too many, but when he's open, he's capable of knocking it down.
So Billy cuts it to a one-point game. Billy, of course, is the son of Ball State football coach Bill Lynch, a two-sport athlete star here at Ball State.
We'll see Lonnie Jones at the next dead ball.
Powell with a fake, and he's feeling it today. Misses that one. Kahn comes off with a rebound for Western.
Looked like Powell was trying to draw some contact from Jackson there. Not a great shot, but Western starts it over. No, they won't.
Good steal by Josh Murray. Quick pass to Jackson. Let him a little bit too much. Jackson finds Cedric. He wants three. No good off the back of the rim. Good hustle by Billy Lynch, and he'll go to the line for two shots.
Cardinals keep the ball, but bad pass by Billy Lynch. 4-on-1, and he threw it ahead to the smallest guy on the floor. You had Smith and you had Moody running next to you. Why not throw it into one of them guys' hands?
Here's a good look at Billy Lynch's three-pointer from the corner. Billy's capable of knocking down those shots when he's open. He'll go to the line for two. Billy's a good free throw shooter for the Cardinals, and he ties the game.
Lynch second only to Cedric Moody from the free throw line.
That last foul was on Robbie Cullum. Billy eyes the second and hits. Well, we got a media timeout. Ball State takes the lead on Billy Lynch's two free throws. You're watching Ball State men's basketball on WCRH.
Central Indiana, there is only one place to turn for local news.
About 2 million Serbian residents.
Ball State has gained national
news
attention.
News Center 43.
America's
on Rule 7.
We're okay on time now, guys.
Clouds begin to fall.
Muncie's only live TV newscast.
Reporting live.
Only live.
On Saturday as we go to the highlight.
An official CNN Student Bureau. News Center 43, Monday through Thursday at 5:30 and 9:30 on Verz Channel 43.
Okay, class, tomorrow night's college night. Think about your needs.
I need to be challenged.
I need,
I need to be my own boss. I need to be his boss, too.
University, everything you need.
Lonnie Jones doing what he does best, follows up the Josh Murray miss with authority.
Reed Druck alongside Todd Bella and Justin Herbers roaming the sideline. Ball State takes a lead on Billy Lynch's two free throws. They lead it 32-31 with 2 minutes and 14 seconds in the first half.
Well, you knew Western wasn't going to continue the hot hand shooting, especially from the outside. They've missed their last six from behind the arc and seven of their last eight from inside.
Justin.
Hello.
How you doing, buddy?
Pretty good, Reed. Hey, I just want to let you guys know, after Western Michigan took that big lead, Ball State took a timeout, and Coach Buckley told the guys just to keep playing good defense. Their three-point percentage will go down, and sure enough, it did, and Ball State's right back in this game.
Thanks a lot, Justin.
Pretty safe bet by Buckley to say they wouldn't continue shooting the way they were.
They started out the game scorching. Ball State now trails. Collum hit a shot down.
A couple of bad passes Moody's made now trying to get the ball down low. Cardinals, 9 turnovers.
Cedric chases the long rebound.
Opportunity to run again.
Good defense by Western as Cullum goes diving for the ball.
Jackson will spell Lynch. Final minute and a half to play in the first half. The Cardinals down one.
A lot of people were skeptical about Billy Lynch before the season started, but I think he's really proved himself as an asset for this team.
Lynch had a good opportunity with Moody's injury to step into the lineup, especially when Patrick Jackson was kind of having to carry on the shooting guard and the point guard role.
Josh Murray continues to struggle down low. 1 of 5 from the field so far tonight. Western Michigan with a 1-point lead. 1 minute to play here in the first half. This is our first telecast of the season for WCRH. Kahn with a nice move down low for Western.
Off the good look from Powell. So Cardinals with a chance here. Get a 2-for-1 if they get a shot off. I'm sure they're not thinking about that. 40 seconds and a half.
Nice move by Lonnie. Can't get it to go. A little slow getting up. 30 seconds to play in the first half. Looks like there's like a sun shadow on the floor right now. I don't know exactly where that's coming from.
I see it too. Right where Patrick Jackson's standing. Maybe they're sending a little sign to Petey.
11 seconds to play. Two second differential on the shot. Kahn with a look, no good, knocked out of bounds, and Ball State will have the last shot of the game.
So 3 seconds left. Let's see if the Cardinals can get a decent look here.
Patrick Jackson gets it. Cedric with a shot, does not get it off. He missed it.
No shot. Shot didn't go in anyways, but it wouldn't have counted if it had. So 9 first half turnovers for Ball State. A sloppy half, the Cardinals find themselves down 3, Reed.
35-32, we'll send it to the break right now. Ball State trails by 3.
Okay class, tomorrow night is college night. Think about your needs.
I need a well-respected degree.
I need to explore. I need a ticket to the world.
Ball State University, everything you need.
Okay, class, tomorrow night is college night. Think about your needs.
I need a cool job.
Choices.
And a lot of technology.
Ball State University, everything you need.
Ball State trails by 3. They trail 35-32. first half. Ball State has 9 turnovers early on, and Western Michigan started out on fire.
Cardinals did take the lead 32-31 before Western scored the final 4 points to close out the half.
Reed Druck alongside Todd Bella here on WCRH Sports. Look at some of the numbers from the first half. Ball State is led in scoring by Lonnie Jones and Cedric Moody. 8 points each for them. Billy Lynch has 5. T. Smith, 4 points. Robbie Owens has 2. Patrick Jackson, 3. And Josh Murray also has 2. For Western Michigan, Collum leads the way with 12 points. Powell has 12 also as he started off hot. 4 of 8 from downtown for Powell. 7 points by Carter and 2 for Kahn. That's the scoring.
Ball State shot 43% from the field, just 12 of 28. They were 4 of 8 from behind the three-point line, so that kind of kept them in it when their shooting touch got cold. Western Michigan, 13 of 29, really cooled off from early on, Reed.
Cedric Moody came off the bench to spark Ball State with 2 three-pointers. A teammate in high school of my color man. What was it like playing with Ced in high school?
Well, I tell you what, we have a little series of horse that we still play on. Cedric and I battle. I said I thought I'd won 4 times. He says 1. So we agreed that he's up like around 60-2 on me in the season series. And you see with his effective ability to knock down the 3-point shot why he beats me every game.
Todd Bella was actually an excellent player in high school. Well, Ball State trails 35-32. It's halftime here at Johnny Worthen Arena. We'll be back for the second half. You're watching Ball State Men's Basketball on WCRH Sports.
Okay, class, tomorrow night's college night. Think about your needs.
I need to be challenged.
I need to be my own boss. I need to be his boss, too.
Ball State University, everything you need.
Night. Think about your needs.
I need a well-respected degree.
I need to explore. I need a ticket to the world.
Ball State University.
Ball State Sports Online. Schedule, results, headlines, features, statistics, game notes, team pages, video and audio clip, biography, email, Ball State links, daily updates. Your only online source for all the latest in Ball State sports. www.bsu.edu/sports.
During the summer, not only did Lonnie Jones practice the drums, he became stronger and improved his play on the basketball court. So what's been the biggest improvement from last year to this year?
My conditioning has gotten a lot better and I've gotten a lot stronger. So that helps in all areas on the court. We're not getting pushed around as much as I was last year. And just like giving me more better position to get more scores on offense and more rebounding. So. The strength has really picked up my game a lot.
Can you describe a typical game down low in the paint with bodies banging around, how physical it is on you and what you try to deliver back to your opponent?
It's just like you're going to war. You got to come prepared to battle every game because you're going to catch elbows, you're going to throw elbows, trying to throw them so that the ref won't see it, and just trying to get your opponent out of his game by being physical with him. So it's a war.
A lot of times the fans get really charged when they see you block a shot, but even more so when you have one of those spectacular dunks that maybe with your size and your ability that is really athletic and really brings the fans to their feet. If you had your choice to have that spectacular dunk or that spectacular block, which would it be?
It would be a dunk because that's 2 points. And 2 points is better than a block to me.
Ray McCallum said last year that Lonnie Jones has the capability to lead the nation in blocked shots. And with that wingspan, Todd, he certainly could.
Jones doing a nice job today. One of the few Ball State players playing well in the first half. He's 3 of 5, 8 points to go along with 4 rebounds.
We got some dancers on the floor, and we got about 5 minutes left in halftime. We'll be back. We'll leave you with a Lonnie Jones dunk, and we'll go to break. You're watching Ball State Men's Basketball on WCRH Sports.
Think about your needs.
I need to express my creativity.
I need help paying for college.
I need activities outside of class.
Ball State University, everything you need.
Western Michigan came out firing early on, and they got the three-point advantage at the half. 35-32, Western Michigan leads it. Field goal percentage, almost the same, 44% for Western, 42 for Ball State. Free throw percentage of Western Broncos hasn't missed yet. Ball State shooting 50%, that is their weakness. That is the weakness on this team. Western started off hot from downtown, but now find themselves just shooting 35%. Ball State, with the aid of Billy Lynch and Cedric Moody, is shooting 50% from downtown. That has actually twisted around. Western Michigan actually has 5 turnovers. Ball State has 9, which was the downfall of the first half of the Cardinals. 13 rebounds to 23, so Ball State controls the boards.
And the steals are a reverse as well. Western doing a nice job taking the ball away. They forced 9 turnovers, 6 steps.
The guys are back on the floor getting warmed up. Cedric Moody came off the bench to score 8 points in the first half. How long, Todd, do you think we'll see before Cedric comes back in the starting lineup?
Well, I don't know. I know Coach Buckley wanted to ease him into a little bit, but Moody's been playing a lot of minutes. And as we've seen the last game against Ohio, he didn't start in the second half, but he was in before even a minute went off the clock.
Robbie Owens have been starting for Cedric Moody while he was absent. Cedric, of course, broke his foot early on, and he missed the first 9 games for Ball State. We got Justin Herber with assistant coach Angus Thorpe. Justin, take it away, pal.
Thanks, guys. Coach Thorpe, Western Michigan came out hot. What did you tell the guys in the timeout to let them be able to come back in this game?
What we wanted to do is basically stay with our fundamentals. We really wanted to get out and get through the screens and contest all the shots. And to their credit, they hit some tough shots, and probably to some of our defense, they got some open looks. So that's something that we wanted to take away this half.
And what are you going to have to do in the second half to ward them off?
What we want to do is offensively, we want to maintain the things that we've been doing the first half, is running the floor and hitting the offensive glass. And we got some great looks inside, and we just missed some. And defensively, we want to make sure that we get out and we still contest all the shots and not give them any easy ones inside.
Thanks a lot, Coach, and good luck in the second half. Back to you, gentlemen.
That was assistant coach Angus Thorpe and Justin Herbert with his halftime comments. Coach Buckley is probably not too pleased with the play of his team in the first half, but they find themselves trailing by only 3 points. It could be a lot worse.
Ball State winning the battle down low. Points in the paint, 16-8. The Cardinals second chance points, 13-2. So offensive rebounds really aiding the Cardinals. They lead the battle on the boards, as we showed in the stats, 23-13.
T. Smith and Coach Buckley going after the second half. What are they going to do in the second half? 9 turnovers for Ball State. That's been the story of the first half. Ball State definitely has to cut that down to be successful in this game.
Cardinals have relied heavily on their bench, particularly Cedric Moody and Lonnie Jones. The two combined for 16 points. Western's gotten just 4 points off the bench out of Kahn and Barry.
We're going to look at the Ball State pom-pom squad. Nice crowd on hand today here at Worthen Arena. This is WCRH's first telecast of the season. Ball State men's basketball, Mid-American Conference action on WCRH. Robert McCollum has his troops together. They'll look to do what they did in the first half.
Western has to come out shooting the ball better from the outside. They hit 5 of their first 7, but then missed their last 7 three-point shots before the break.
No blocks for Lonnie Jones in the first half. However, he did have 8 points and 4 rebounds.
They never keep Lonnie Jones' block statistics correct anyways. We always comment on that. But one game in particular against Anderson, we thought Jones had about 6 blocks. Reed and I did.
Welcome back to this basketball game between Ball State and Western Michigan. Right now, Western Michigan leads 35-32. Earlier today, we had the women's team play, and they beat Northern Illinois 78-54. Next, we have a story that was done last year at Ball State about Ball State's big man. Turns out that Ball State's big man, Lonnie Jones, likes to jam on more than just the baskets.
What? They kept you on for like 10 seconds.
Just a sophomore, Lonnie Jones has developed into one of the Mid-American Conference's most exciting players. He leads the MAC with nearly 2.5 blocks per game, plus he has increased his points and rebounds production from a year ago. His spectacular blocks and high-flying jams have made Jones a fan favorite, but outside of University Arena and away from the basketball court, Jones enjoys a different kind of jam session.
Well, a lot of times when people have seen me play, they just, like the next day would come up to me, "Oh, I didn't know you played the drums," and just like, they wouldn't expect that from me. I was in band in high school, and I took lessons for like a month, but then I stopped because I really wasn't learning what I wanted to learn. So I just really got into it on my own. I always have liked playing the drums, so whenever I get an opportunity to, I'm going to, so. It's just like after basketball and after my schoolwork and drum.
Pretty good for someone who stands 6'11", but Jones doesn't just bang away on the drums after basketball is over. He practices and performs weekly with a local church choir in Muncie.
They rehearse on Thursday nights and then services on Sunday, so whenever we're not practicing, I go if I can make it.
Playing the drums, is it sort of a stress reliever for you, or a way to take out maybe any anger or frustrations that you have on a basketball court? If you're not blocking the shots, do you go home and bang on the drums?
Well, it's not like, I'm not really too angry that much, but I mean, it just takes my mind off everything else, and I enjoy doing it, so it's like a hobby for me.
During the summer, not only did Lonnie Jones practice the drums, he became stronger and improved his play on the basketball court. So what's been the biggest improvement from last year to this year?
My conditioning has gotten a lot better, and I've gotten a lot stronger. So that helps in all areas on the court. We're not getting pushed around as much as I was last year. And just like giving me more better position to get more scores on offense. and more rebounding. So the strength has really picked up my game a lot.
Can you describe a typical game down low in the paint with bodies banging around, how physical it is on you and what you try to deliver back to your opponent?
It's just like you're going to war. You got to come prepared to battle every game because you're going to catch elbows, you're going to throw elbows, trying to throw them so that the ref won't see it, and just trying to get your opponent out of his game by being physical with him. So it's a war.
A lot of times the fans get really charged when they see you block a shot, but even more so when you have one of those spectacular dunks that maybe with your size and your ability that is really athletic and really brings the fans to their feet. If you had your choice to have that spectacular dunk or that spectacular block, which would it be?
It would be a dunk because that's 2 points. And 2 points is better than a block to me.
Ray McCallum said last year that Lonnie Jones has the capability to lead the nation in block shots. And with that wingspan, Todd, he certainly could.
Jones doing a nice job today. One of the few Ball State players playing well in the first half. He's 3 of 5, 8 points to go along with 4 rebounds.
We got some dancers on the floor, and we got about 5 minutes left in halftime. We'll be back. We'll leave you with a Lonnie Jones dunk, and we'll go to break. You're watching Ball State Men's Basketball on WCRH Sports.
Think about your needs.
I need to express my creativity.
I need help paying for college.
I need activities outside of class.
Ball State University.
Western Michigan came out firing early on, and they got the three-point advantage at the half. 35-32, Western Michigan leads it. Field goal percentage, almost the same, 44% for Western, 42 for Ball State. Free throw percentage of Western Broncos hasn't missed yet. Ball State shooting 50%, that is their weakness. That is the weakness on this team. Western started off hot from downtown, but now find themselves just shooting 35%. Ball State, with the aid of Billy Lynch and Cedric Moody, is shooting 50% from downtown. That has actually twisted around. Western Michigan actually has 5 turnovers. Ball State has 9, which was the downfall of the first half of the Cardinals. 13 rebounds to 23, so Ball State controls the boards.
And the steals are a reverse as well. Western doing a nice job taking the ball away. They forced 9 turnovers, 6 steps.
The guys are back on the floor getting warmed up. Cedric Moody came off the bench to score 8 points in the first half. How long, Todd, do you think we'll see before Cedric comes back in the starting lineup?
Well, I don't know. I know Coach Buckley wanted to ease him into a little bit, but Moody's been playing a lot of minutes. And as we've seen the last game against Ohio, he didn't start in the second half, but he was in before even a minute went off the clock.
Robbie Owens have been starting for Cedric Moody while he was absent. Cedric, of course, broke his foot early on, and he missed the first 9 games for Ball State. We got Justin Herbert with assistant coach Anger Thorpe. Justin, take it away, pal.
Thanks, guys. Coach Thorpe, Western Michigan came out hot. What did you tell the guys in the timeout to let them come back in this game?
What we wanted to do is basically stay with our fundamentals. We really wanted to get out and get through the screens and contest all the shots. And to their credit, they hit some tough shots, and probably to some of our defense, they got some open looks. So that's something that we wanted to take away this half.
And what are you going to have to do in the second half to ward them off?
what we want to do is offensively, we want to maintain the thing that we've been doing the first half, is running the floor and hitting the offensive glass. And we got some great looks inside, and we just missed some. And defensively, we want to make sure that we get out and we still contest all the shots and not give them any easy ones inside.
Thanks a lot, Coach, and good luck in the second half. Back to you, gentlemen.
That was assistant coach Angus Thorpe and Justin Herbert with his halftime comments. Coach Buckley is probably not too pleased with the play of his team in the first half, but they find themselves trailing by only 3 points. It could be a lot worse.
Ball State winning the battle down low. Points in the paint, 16-8. The Cardinals' second chance points, 13-2. So offensive rebounds really aiding the Cardinals. They lead the battle on the boards, as we showed in the stats, 23-13.
T. Smith and Coach Buckley going after the second half. What are they going to do in the second half? 9 turnovers for Ball State. That's been the story of the first half. Ball State definitely has to cut that down to be successful in this game.
Cardinals have relied heavily on their bench, particularly Cedric Moody and Lonnie Jones. The two combined for 16 points. Western's gotten just 4 points off the bench out of Kahn and Barry.
We're going to look at the Ball State pom-pom squad. Nice crowd on hand today here at Worthen Arena. This is WCRH's first telecast of the season. Ball State men's basketball, Mid-American Conference action on WCRH. Robert McCollum has his troops together. They'll look to do what they did in the first half.
Western has to come out shooting the ball better from the outside. They hit 5 of their first 7, but then missed their last 7 3-point shots before the break.
No blocks for Lonnie Jones in the first half. However, he did have 8 points and 4 rebounds.
They never keep Lonnie Jones' block statistics correct anyways. We always comment on that. But one game in particular against Anderson, we thought Jones had about 6 blocks, Reed and I did. Remember, he had about 3 in the stat column?
3 in the box score. Billy Lynch, Josh Murray, Lonnie Jones will start the second half. Patrick Jackson and T. Smith in for Ball State. Robbie Owens is on the bench to start off the second half. Here's Lonnie Jones out quick. Good rebound by Murray, and he puts it in.
Nice job by Murray. Thought he should have went right back up with that rather than came down. Josh went underneath with a little reverse.
Western starts the same lineup. Here's Cullen for Western. Reynolds wants 3. No good.
It's really the first good look Reynolds has got. His only second shot of the game, third shot of the game. Nice job by Murray to get out on him.
T. Smith with a long miss in the corner. So Western missed on their first possession. Hit the first 4 3-pointers they took in the first half. Powell with a nice drive, and he'll go to the line for 2. I think the foul's on Josh Murray. Be his second personal foul. So Powell will go to the line. Powell with a very impressive first half, 12 points, 2 of 4 from downtown, 2 of 2 from the charity stripe.
And 5 of the small 14 rebounds Western had.
Powell hits the first. Get a look at Powell getting fouled there. Josh Murray.
Murray is guilty.
Second free throw is good. So Western goes back up 3. 37-34 early on in the second half. Billy Lynch calls out the play for the Ball State Cardinals. Patrick Jackson in the corner for 3. Got it. So Patrick ties it up with 1 shot, 37 all.
Nice screen by Josh Murray to get Petey open on the wing.
Collin barks out the signals for Western.
Crowd's starting to show a little life here.
It's Patrick Jackson with a quick steal. It's him and Murray. He'll take it all the way. It's good.
Petey knocked to the floor, no call.
This is Ball State's first lead since early in the first half. They lead at 39-37.
Cardinals actually did take a 1-point lead with around 2 minutes to play in the first half before Western closed out the half with 4 straight.
Collin misses the free throw. Reynolds with a nice rebound. Jones comes off with it, and he's fouled by Powell.
So the pace of the game has picked up a little bit, and it's beginning to favor Ball State. Western foul on the rebound.
One of our keys to the game was those quick, easy transition buckets for Ball State. As we'll see, Patrick Jackson go for a nice looking three-pointer from the corner.
What you didn't see there was Jackson to Lynch, and then Josh Murray gave him the screen and a nice pass back to Jackson for the easy open look.
Josh Murray has it in the corner. Here's Billy, thought about the shot, didn't take it. T. Smith in the corner, he's open for three, and he's got it.
Smith wide open. Sometimes that's the toughest shot in basketball when you're all alone.
Ball State of 42-37, their biggest lead of the game. Finally starting to do it on the offensive end, Ball State is. Here's Reynolds for three, and he's got it.
So Reynolds answers the two three-pointers from Ball State. Smith and Jackson, Cardinals hitting two out of their first three, come out looking like Western did.
That's Reynolds' first bucket of the game. He's their leading scorer. The 1-12 Western Michigan against the 6-5 Ball State Cardinals. T. Smith again from downtown.
That's 7-12 now from Ball State from behind the line.
Cedric Moody will check back in, as you see at the top of your screen, on the next dead ball. The crowd's finally getting into it here in Muncie. Ball State's pumped up. Here's Carter. The pass to Reynolds. He fakes. Now there's Powell. Powell misses. Long rebound off to Billy Lynch.
Lynch splitting the defense to pull it out here.
Patrick Jackson for T again. No good. He falls to the ground. And Josh Murray with a rebound and a bucket.
Right place, right time once again for Josh Murray.
Ball State leads it by seven now, and Coach McCollum wants a timeout for Western. So Todd, we've seen Ball State get some open shots, and they're finally winning this game.
Cardinals on a 15-5 run to start the second half.
We'll look at one of T. Smith's three-point shots. Actually, this is the miss by T in the corner. Actually hits the side of the backboard. Josh Murray gets it and puts it in for the easy two. You saw on the WCRH scoreboard, Ball State leads at 47-40, 16-31 to play in the game. There's Charlie Cardinal doing his dance. And gets booed for it for some reason. Ball State, Cedric Moody checks back in. Billy Lynch will take a seat.
T. Smith just 4-10 from the field, but hit two of the last three from behind the arc. He's got 10 points, leads the team in net, and six rebounds as well.
Call him for three, and he's got it. A three-point barrage here in the second half by both teams. Here's Lonnie. Nice turnaround shot, no good. T. tries to get the rebound, knocked away.
Smith was above the basket right there, couldn't tap it in. Call him 3-9 from behind the line. From behind three-point range, hit that last one there. He's got 15 points, Powell with 14, and Smith for Ball State, the only three players in double figures.
Ball State controls. Patrick thought about the three, pulls it back out, calls out a play. Ball State's been in control so far in the second half.
I like this lineup read for Ball State. This is the lineup everyone anticipated coming into this season prior to the Moody injury. We haven't really seen it too much this season.
See if they can gel as a unit. 10 seconds on the shot clock. T. Smith out to Patrick. Patrick wants three. Got it!
That's a two-pointer. Two-pointer. Jackson with the head fake. Took a couple steps in.
Nonetheless, Ball State is on fire in the second half. Billy Lynch will check back in on the next dead ball. Western trails by six, and they have the ball. This is Taylor Burrow up top. Nice drive. He's fouled. Looked like Patrick had pretty good positioning, but he'll get the call on him. .49-43, 15-23 to go. There's Coach Tim Buckley. It's in his first year. Graduate of Bemidji State. So Bro will be at the line for the first time today. He's only taken one shot. He missed it. Taylor Bro comes in the game averaging 6 points a game. A 66% free throw shooter, and he hits the first. So Lynch will check back in for Ball State. Reggie Berry back in for Western Michigan.
And Bro hurt the Cardinals a little bit last year, pulling down 9 rebounds in the contest at Muncie.
So Bro will try to cut it to a 4-point Cardinal lead with his second free throw. He hits it, and with that, we got a media timeout. Ball State comes out firing the second half. They got a 4-point lead. You're watching Ball State men's basketball on WCRH.
Central Indiana, there is only one place to turn for local news.
About 2 million Serbian residents.
Ball State has gained national
news
attention.
News Center 43.
America's
and Rule 7.
We're okay on time now, guys.
Clouds begin to form.
Muncie's only live TV newscast.
Reporting live. Only live. On Saturday as we go to the highlight.
An official CNN Student Bureau. CNN Student Bureau. News Center 43, Monday through Thursday at 5:30 and 9:30 on Burr's Channel 43.
Okay, class, tomorrow night's college night. Think about your needs.
I need to be challenged.
I need to be my own boss. I need to be his boss, too.
Ball State University, everything you need.
Petey Jackson here knocks down the jumper. Ball State with a 4-point lead just 4.5 minutes into the second half. Ball State, as I said, 7 of their first 12 to start the second half and 4 of their first 6 from 3-point range.
Ball State's came out firing here in the second half. I wonder what Coach Buckley told the troops to get them riled up.
I don't think it's been so much anything Buckley may have said, just better looking shots. Smith's 3-pointers that he hit, the 2, he was open. Petey Jackson on his couple of jump shots wide open. Western not doing as good a job defending the perimeter as they did in the first half.
I'll set the lineup for you for Ball State. Murray Lynch, Moody Smith, and Patrick Jackson. Lonnie Jones will take a seat.
Moody's yet to get a look here in the second half. Let's see if Coach Buckley designs something for him coming out of the timeout.
Billy Lynch with a shot, no good. T with a nice rebound, and he's fouled.
Western really doesn't have anyone down low to handle, T, Murray, or Lonnie. Cardinals 31-15 rebounding advantage right now.
Theron will go to the free throw stripe where he's 0-for-2 tonight.
Team foul number 2 against Western.
Missed his only 2 free throw attempts in the last home game against Ohio.
T. Smith at the free throw line. Shoots a pair.
First one's good. No good, excuse me.
So Ball State, the Achilles in the first half was the turnovers. Cardinals yet to give the ball away in the first 5 minutes of the second half.
See some of T's numbers there as he sinks the second free throw. Kahn checks back in for the first time in the second half for Western Michigan. Total 2 points in the first half.
So T. Smith knocked down the second free throw after getting fouled. Just throwing that upper body strength around inside, and there you see he's knocked from behind.
Western Michigan will look to cut into this 5-point lead by Ball State. Cedric Moody and Powell up top. Got a whistle down low and it's on Murray. Doesn't quite agree with the call.
Talk about T's upper body strength, Reed. His brother, Happy Smith, a professional boxer in middleweight class, 13-0. So an athletic family.
So basically what you're saying is don't mess with the Smiths down there in Auburndale, Florida.
No, not at all.
Western Michigan has it underneath. Quick pass to Reynolds. Good looking out of bounds play, but Reynolds couldn't put it down.
It's about as nice of a shot as you're going to get if you're Steve Reynolds. Ball State keyed on.
Great pass by Billy Lynch, and T. Smith is fouled down low. He'll go back to the free throw line.
Smith wanted the exciting play in the slam there, but he might have been able to get a 3-point play had he just laid it in. Seen the contact coming, so T will march right back to the free throw line where he hit his second. I don't know how you can leave a guy like T. Smith wide open down low, but Western did right there.
Lynch has 4 assists so far tonight.
Smith now 1-of-5 from the free throw line. Ball State is a team 5-of-11. Cardinals have struggled throughout this season, and especially last year from the free throw line.
In some key moments last year, Ball State could have put games away. Free throw shooting prohibited that. Last game against Eastern Michigan, T. Smith led all scorers with 23 points and had an outstanding game. He knocks down the second. Ball State leads by 6.
Smith with 12 points now to lead the way for the Cards.
51-45, 14:40 to play. Mid-America Conference basketball on WCRH, our first telecast of the season. Reed Druck alongside Todd Bella. Here's Powell.
Tough shot.
It's actually Reynolds with the miss. Kahn comes on the rebound and blocked by Lonnie Jones.
I'm not so sure if Lonnie got that or the side of the backboard, but hopefully we'll give Lonnie a block. You know how generous they are in that department.
They did not give Lonnie a block. T comes off the rebound, his ninth of the game. It's knocked away, and Ball State will have it.
Carter had T's left arm right there. Smith trying to corral the rebound, so Ball State gets it out of bounds. Western fortunate a foul wouldn't call.
Billy Lynch will bring it across for the Cardinals. Patrick Jackson thought he was going to be the starting point guard this year until Billy Lynch came in, took it away. T wants three. No good. Rebound by center. And he can't get it to go either.
So Moody in there amongst the trees, went up with the left, couldn't get it to fall.
You know, Cedric's not as tall as the bigger guys out there. He sure has the same leaps as them. Western's been stuck on 45 for a while. Got a reach in foul. It's going to be on T. Smith.
Fourth team foul for Ball State. I believe that's Smith's second. Yes, it is.
Coach Buckley doesn't like what he sees on that call.
Western Michigan doing a nice job here in the second half avoiding foul trouble. They picked up about five or six quick ones in the first half. They've had 11 guys foul out this season, Reed, and they're averaging 23 fouls a game. But most of that you can attribute to having to foul toward the end of the ball game since they've been on the losing end so many times.
Western Michigan's not a bad team as Reggie Berry hits it. Need to get some confidence as they play in the Mid-America Conference season. Todd and I had a chance to travel to Western Michigan earlier in the week to watch the ladies play, a beautiful facility at University Arena in Kalamazoo, Michigan. Nice campus.
So four players spread around the perimeter and just Jones down low. Cardinals struggling to get something going on this trip.
Patrick Jackson with a drive. That leaves T open for three.
Got it. Right when it left his hands there, you knew it was in. Smith, his third three-point field goal of the game, give them 15 points and give Ball State their seven-point lead.
What I like in the stat line for T, he's taken 13 shots. Last home game, Theron only took four shots.
One of the things that happened when Cedric Moody's returned, Moody, of course, leading the team 19 points a game, that took away some of T's shots. He's such an unselfish player.
Lonnie trying to add to the block total. Gets called for a foul. T. Smith now is tied for
45, Lonnie Jones picks up his third foul.
Most points today.
Number five against Ball State. 23, Reggie Berry.
Lonnie's third foul there going for the block. You see he got part of the left arm of Berry. So interesting to see what Coach Buckley does here with the big center. Does he keep him in with three fouls or does he take him out? He hasn't done anything yet.
Berry's first free throw attempts of the game. He's got 2 points. He hits the first.
Billy Lynch had to be careful there. Lynch almost crossed the free throw line extended there during Berry's free throw.
Six-four guard out of Houston, Texas. Second free throw is also good. Justin Herber on the sidelines.
Yeah, yes, fellas, I just wanted to tell you guys, just some FYI, might that serve me correct. T. Smith is one rebound away from his seventh double-double of the season. Back to you.
Actually, the stats say T's only got 8 rebounds, so 2 away from his seventh double-double of the season. Thank you, Justin.
Western Michigan, 10-10 from the free throw line.
Broncos came into the game shooting about 65%. 100% on today. Kahn with a nice move in the left-handed strip shot.
I was going to say Kahn's not going to hurt you out there where you caught the ball, but he took a couple dribbles in and the good left.
That's Kahn's fourth point of the contest. Ball State finds their lead, only to be 3. Billy Lynch has it for the Cardinals. Good pass down to Lonnie. Lonnie tries to get it to T. Big fella not known for his passing. Powell runs the break for Western. Cedric Moody guards Barrett. Western Michigan will set it back up. They got 20 seconds on the shot clock. Reynolds. Nice move around Lonnie Jones. And
so back-to-back possessions. First Conn and then Reynolds. They go right at Lonnie Jones. Jones protecting the three fouls. Ball State wants to talk things over.
Coach Buckley seated up. He wants a 30-second timeout. Saw on the WCRH scoreboard, Ball State still leads by one, 54-53. 11:09 to play in the game.
Cardinals will next be in action Monday here at Worthen Arena against Northern Illinois before traveling for their first real road test in the conference season at Toledo.
And next Wednesday, the Ball State women's basketball team will be at home to host the Ohio Bobcats. You can catch all the action on 91.3 WCRD.
Reynolds starting to get things going offensively. You've seen him put that basket in there. He has 5 points after being held scoreless in the first half.
54-53, 11:09 to play in the first half, or in the second half. Western Michigan came out firing in the first half as we see some Western Michigan faithful in the crowd.
Few.
Not a bad trip to Kalamazoo, or from Kalamazoo to Muncie. About a 3-hour trip by bus. Here's Billy Lynch in the corner for three, no good. Knocked around, saved by Conn into Lonnie Jones. He misses it, T with the flush off the rebound.
Coach McCollum from Ball State kind of shaking his head. I think he'd rather see I'd rather have seen Conn just kind of sit on that ball and go out of bounds with it rather than throw it into Lonnie Jones.
56-53, Ball State leads by three. Here's Powell in the corner for three, and he ties it up.
Reed, I was watching Coach McCollum to see what he'd do there. He wanted to call timeout. Referees didn't see it, so instead they get the three-point basket.
McCollum discussing it with the official. Carter with some pressure. Great Mid-American Conference game. Here's Cedric for three. No good. A little long for Cedric.
Ball State was patient there offensively, but they didn't settle for the good shot.
A long three by Powell, and he hits it. He is feeling it. Pass down low to T. And he scored. It looked like he was fouled on the play. It should have been an air one. We got an offensive foul down low on Powell.
33 Powell called for the offensive foul.
There's Keith Smith flushing it home after the Jones missed. The Cardinal big fellas work well together. They've had about 3 or 4 putbacks following each other's misses. 36-20, the Cardinals dominating on the board.
Well, we got a timeout on the floor. Ball State trails by one. You're watching Ball State men's basketball on WCRH.
Okay, class, tomorrow night's college night. Think about your needs.
I need a cool job.
I need choices.
And a lot of technology.
Ball State University, everything you need.
Okay, class, tomorrow night's college night. Think about your needs.
I need a well-respected degree.
I need to explore. I need a ticket to the world.
Ball State University, everything you need.
Combined to shoot 17 of 38 from behind the line. That three by Powell right there, well behind the three-point line. And T. Smith wide open. He'll hit that one. He's 3 of 7 from behind the line. 19 points to go along with his 9 rebounds. 59-58, Western in the lead. And I think it's safe to say, Reed, that this 1-12 record may be a little bit deceptive, especially as the Broncos starting to play better ball as of late.
Well, Western's played some good teams. They started out in some tough games. They played Michigan earlier in the season. They played
Indiana,
of course.
What I was going to say is the Broncos, after beating Ohio, lost by 9 to Detroit, then in overtime to Oakland before hanging in, dropping only a 2-point decision to Eastern leading Marshall.
Billy Lynch in the corner to T. Smith. Lonnie Jones wants it down low.
Josh Murray came in for Cedric Moody after that break, so the Cardinals going with a little more size.
Here's Patrick for three. No good. T's going to get caught for an over the back. Justin Herbert's on the sidelines. What you got, buddy?
Thanks, gentlemen. I just want to tell you from that last timeout, Coach Buckley told the team that this game was going to be won on the defensive end. And if people didn't start playing better defense, he was going to pull them for personnel who did. So Coach Buckley is very serious right now and also says that they need to set better traps on defense. That's all from the sidelines, fellas.
Coach Buckley installing discipline into this team.
Steve Reynolds, another three-point field goal. 10 three-pointers for Western. Reynolds now with 8 points.
You saw at the top of your screen Cedric Moody come off the bench. He'll check back in on the next dead ball. Patrick Jackson calls the play up top. Ball State trails by four with 8 minutes and 30 seconds to play here at Worthen Arena. Mid-American Conference basketball on WCRH. Here's T. Smith with a long two. No good. Lonnie Jones with a rebound. Puts it up. No good. T comes in for the rebound. He's fouled it. No good.
So three chances right there, and Ball State will get a couple of free throws. Smith will, trying to cut into this four-point lead.
T will go to the line, or he's not too successful today. 2 of 6 from the stripe. He has a double-double, 19 points and 10 rebounds, as Justin said earlier. It's his seventh of the season. 6-5 Ball State Cardinals battling the 1-12 Western Michigan Broncos. T's first free throw is good.
Western Michigan, we talked about 10 of 22, just 3 three-pointers away from tying the record here at Worthen Arena.
Western Michigan, 10 of 22, an outstanding three-point field goal percentage. Theron Smith at the line, I'll try to get another one. Coach Buckley and Angus Thorpe on the sidelines. He misses it off the back of the rim, and a rebound comes off to Moody. Moody with a bad pass, but Billy saves a great hustle by Billy Lynch. T. Smith, Eric shot, Jones!
Attempted by a team. We're nowhere near that mark as Troy State, 36 attempts back in 96. That was back when they used to play that Loyola Marymount type offense. Western Michigan taking 22 threes, Ball State with 18.
The crowd's into it here at Worthen Arena. Ball State trails by one. 12 seconds on the shot clock. Down to five. Here's Slater who checked in. Cullen wants three. No good off the front of the rim. Tapped around.
And thrown right off of our monitor here. Lonnie Jones caught that T. Smith. The bad shot by Smith, but when you got a guy like Lonnie down low able to save it, you can afford to make misses like that. The Cardinals trail by one as we go into our timeout here on WCRH Sports.
Think about your needs.
I need to express my creativity.
I need help paying for college.
I need activities outside of class.
Ball State University.
Lonnie Jones trying to slam the Cardinals back into this. They trail by one, 62-61. Talking about the bombs being shot today, 23 for Western Michigan. The Cardinals have attempted 18 three-point field goals. Last year, Ball State versus Chaminade, the teams combined for 52, a Worthen Arena record. Chaminade, of course, the host of the Maui Invitational, where Ball State will play next year.
Can't wait for that. Ball State trails by one. Earlier in the day, Ball State women's basketball improved to 12-3, 4-0 in the MAC as they beat Northern Illinois, 78-54. Tamara Bowie led the way with 21 points. Lori Kitts added 15.
Bowie, an impressive 15-16 from the free throw line.
Ties a new Worthen Arena. Knocked out of bounds, Western will have it. 7:06 to play, Ball State trails by one, 62-61.
What we've seen on the Cardinals' offensive end, especially a couple times in the second half, is Western not able to hang with Jones and Smith and Murray on the boards, kind of slapping away at the ball. That time they hit it, T. Smith knocked it out of bounds.
Ball State controlling the boards, 40-22. Western will look to add to their lead on this possession. 19 seconds on the shot clock. Here's Reynolds open in the corner. Lonnie Jones got a piece of it, and Ball State has it. 6. Cedric Moody down to Jones. Lonnie turns. No good. We had a foul. It'll be on Western's number two, Taylor Brough.
Brough kind of bailed the Cardinals out. I thought Lonnie should have kicked that ball back out. Nobody underneath. Three guys kind of swarmed to him. Moody, Jackson, and Lynch around the perimeter.
Khan checks back in for Western.
Back shirt 21. It's
team foul number 6 against Western.
Each team with 6 fouls now will both be shooting after the next foul. Jones misses the shot, but there you see Brough and Cullum. One of them got him down there, and it's Brough.
Both teams will be in the bonus on the next foul. Here's T. Smith. He lays it in. And Ball State regains the lead, 63-62.
Forgot to tell you, T. Smith is in that double-double area Justin Herbert was talking about. 22 points now and 11 rebounds. Smith doing a lot of the dirty work.
Western has it. They trail by 1 point. We come upon 6 minutes to play. 3-point shootout here at Worthen Arena today. Here's Cullum. 6 seconds to shoot. Reynolds has to put it up. Here's Khan. He misses off the back rim. T gets another rebound. His 12th, and he's going to be fouled by Reynolds. That'll be Reynolds' 3rd foul.
One of the advantages the Cardinals have during this final stretch is playing in close ball games. Of Western's 12 losses, 8 of them have been by double figures.
Theron Smith will go to the line. It hasn't been too friendly for him today.
So T. Smith goes back to where he's been a lot today, the free throw line. He's just 3 of 8, because Reynolds got him right there. That's 3 on Reynolds. Seems like he has more. He picked up 2 quick ones, just his first foul since the opening few minutes.
Reynolds only has 8 points today. Leading scorer on Western Michigan's team.
Coming in scoring over 15 a game, but Cullum and Powell have really picked up the slack.
T. Smith's free throw is no good. Cedric comes off with another rebound off a free throw. Cedric's 2nd rebound off a free throw today. This is Lynch up top. Finds Lonnie. Bad pass by the big fella. And Cullum's running with it. 3-pointer for Powell. No good off the back of the rim. Cedric comes off with another rebound.
7 rebounds for Moody now. And Reed, I still fail to see why we continue to give our big man the ball at the top of the key.
Cedric having a solid performance. No points in the second half. Here's Billy for 3. Way long. And Powell comes off with a long rebound. It's 2-on-1 with Reynolds. Powell taking himself and score.
But Powell might have taken some steps there. So did the crowd. That long rebound, really no last line of defense with Lynch taking the shot.
64-63. Western takes back the lead. It's been a seesaw battle in the second half. 4 minutes and 40 seconds to play. Patrick Jackson pulls up, no good. Coach Buckley doesn't like that shot. Ball State, who started off strong in the second half, have gone a little cold. Ball State's down a 3-2 zone. It'll be a 1-2-2 set. Call them up top. They got 10 seconds to shoot. They're taking their time with this offense.
They get it into their senior's hands. Powell, he's the team leader.
Powell pulls up, short on the 3. Colin comes away with it, and a foul on Patrick Jackson.
Long shots produce long rebounds. Getting back to Powell. Comes in averaging just over 11 points a game. Scored in double figures, averaging 13. Scored in double figures in all four conference games. But today, 22 points, 7 of 14 from the field, and 4 of 9 from long range.
Collin will go to the line, where he's 2 of 2 today. He has 15 points, a solid performance by Rob Collin.
Robbie Collin doing a nice job as well. Started 12 of the 13 games this season. Came in averaging just over 8. Picked up Steve Reynolds' slack, as we talked about, as he's got 16 now.
Collin hits the first one.
Patrick Jackson said, I didn't get him.
Looks like Patrick was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. As Collin eyes the second hit, pushes the lead to 3 for Weston. 66-63, 4 minutes exactly to play in the second half. Billy Lynch, Josh Murray, Lonnie Jones, Cedric Moody, and T. Smith into the Cardinals.
Some confusion on the Ball State offensive end. Moody and Smith kind of bumped into each other.
T. Smith wants to drive. He does. Pulls up. Nice pass to Lonnie, who gets it to roll. Great play by T. Smith to find open Jones.
A big basket right there. Western has shown they'll be patient offensively. Cardinals with a miss right there. Back to the defensive end, down 3. Instead, Lonnie's looking to tie things up.
Lonnie's 2 of 3 from the line today. This is a big one. With 3 minutes and 44 seconds to play, they trail by 1. Lonnie can tie it up with 1 shot at the line. Lonnie comes out with a different hairstyle every game. Today he's got the part going.
Let's see him part the rim here and knock this up. Lonnie's got 13 to go along with 9 rebounds. We're knotted up. Just under 4 minutes to play. We got a break in the action on WCRH Sports.
Okay, class, tomorrow night's college night. Think about your needs.
I need to be inspired. I need personal attention from professors who care.
I need a kick in the...
Ball State University, everything you need.
Ball State Sports Online. Schedule, result, headline, features, statistics, game note, team pages, video and audio clip, biography, email, Ball State Link, daily updates. Your only online source for all the latest in Ball State sports. www.bsu.edu/sports.
Lonnie Jones getting the big three-point play here to knot things back up at 66. Ball State doing a nice job, Reed, protecting the ball after 9 first-half turnovers. Cardinals really slowed things down, have only given the ball away 3 times here in the second half.
And this is what Mid-American Conference basketball is about. 3 minutes and 44 seconds of play, it's all tied up. The Mid-American Conference kind of got some coverage last year in one of the most exciting basketball tournaments I've ever seen, Todd. We went to Cleveland for the MAC tournament, and every game was close, and it was exciting to watch every game.
That's how the conference season is, and that's why it's so important for the Cardinals to come away with this game at home, and in particular to Western Michigan, a team just 1-3.
Western Michigan has it with 3 minutes and 43 seconds to play. Tight game all the way through. Western had an early advantage, but Ball State has battled back.
Western trying to run Reynolds off of some screens coming out of the timeout.
Kahn gets it away from him. Patrick Jackson chases it down. 12 seconds on the shot clock for Western. Call him the Reynolds. Reynolds wants a long 3, no good. Another long rebound. That one goes off to Barry.
You just get a feeling if Western can stay in this, keep hanging around like they've done, they may catch a break here at the end of the game.
This is Powell. 20 seconds on the shot clock. Western takes their time in their offense.
No inside presence offensively for Western. We talked about Ball State having a huge size advantage.
Cullum's shot is in and out, but Western comes off with another one. Ball State knocks it off of Western's knee, and Ball State will have it.
Coach McCollum upset with the call right there. We're going to send it over to Justin Herbert on the sidelines. Justin, what do you got for us?
Thanks, fellas. In that last timeout, Coach Buckley told the team to go to man-to-man. I don't know if you noticed in that last set, Ball State was going man-to-man. And from here on out, he's going to call out to the players to tell them what defense they're going to be running from here on out. And other than that, he just set up
some
plays.
Whatever defense the Cardinals are in, they're going to need to prevent the outside shooting as Western really lit them up early in the game. They're 10 of 27 right now from behind the three-point line. Ball State not too bad either, 8 of 19, but the Cardinals give it back.
Billy Lynch with an errant pass. You see the three-point field goal percentage. Western started off strong, going kind of cold.
Timeout, Western.
30-second timeout taken by Western. Of Western's 54 shots, Todd, 27 of them have been from downtown. They have not had anything down low. But credit that to the inside play of Ball State's defense. They haven't let them get it down low.
Not a lot of size down low, especially going against Lonnie Jones. Jones has altered some shots, but he really hasn't been the inside presence that he has been in the Mid-American Conference games, particularly because of the long-range shots.
T. Smith leads the way with 22 points and 12 rebounds. A very solid performance from Lonnie Jones. 13 points and 9 rebounds off the bench for the big fella. Cedric has 8 and 7. Patrick Jackson has 10 points and 4 rebounds. Patrick Jackson only taking 8 shots so far in this game.
And if you look ahead on who to foul, it looked like you wouldn't want to foul anybody in this Western team. They're 12 of 12 from the free throw line. But this is a team that shoots 70% from the free throw line, actually 66%, check that. And out of the people in the lineup, Anthony Kahn with the worst percentage below 60.
9 turnovers for Ball State in the first half. They've cut it to 4 in the second. 2 minutes to play here at Worthen Arena. 6 on the shot clock for Western. Ball State and Western Michigan tied up at 66. Not now. Reggie Berry hits a 3 and they lead by 3. 69-66, Western takes the lead.
Berry's first 3-point field goal of the game. 5 Western Michigan Broncos have hit from the outside and Ball State throws it away again. Second straight possession, 2 straight turnovers for the Cardinals.
Horrible pass by Lonnie Jones, and with a minute 35, now Western finds himself with the lead and the ball. Billy Lynch will pick Collum up behind half court. Ball State's in a man-to-man.
Key series right here for Ball State on defense. The two first-year coaches battling it out. The 3-point ball game with a minute and a half to play.
Ball State trails by 3. Been a good game so far.
Reynolds may have got poked in the eye.
Timeout taken by Western Michigan.
Look for a second like Reynolds grabbed his eye before Smith went over for the double team.
A minute 18 to play, Ball State trails by 3, and what a big shot the freshman Reggie Berry put down on the last possession for Western.
Berry 3 of 4 from the field, 9 points to go along with 6 rebounds. So he's having a nice, solid game.
Ball State has 4 free players in double figures, led by T. Smith with 22 points. Powell has 22 for Western Michigan. Collum added 17.
Cardinals next in action Monday, as we told you, against Northern Illinois right here at Worthen Arena before traveling to Toledo on Wednesday.
The ladies beat Northern Illinois in the first game of the doubleheader here at Johnny Worthen Arena. Could see the NCAA banner hanging atop Worthen Arena.
Ball State lost to UCLA in the first round last year. What an athletic UCLA team, to say the least.
What a fun team it was to watch and follow last year was these Ball State Cardinals. A minute and 9 seconds to play. 69-66, Ball State needs some defense. Reynolds for 3, he's got it.
Oh, man.
And that was a backbreaker for the Cardinals. They're going to have to score quick.
Still a minute left. You don't have to take a bad shot.
That's a good shot, though. Off the back of Cedric. T gets it knocked away. No foul called. And we're under a minute to play. And this one might be over. Western leads at 72-66.
Cardinals looking to foul, and they foul Bro. Actually, that's going to be Powell. Powell, a 72% free throw shooter on the year over the last 4 games. Just 7 of 8, I should say. He's only attempted 8 shots.
Reynolds with a backbreaker in the on the last possession as he hits another three-pointer. It's been the story today. They've hit 12 threes.
Somewhat surprising. Give credit to Western Michigan coach McCollum to set up a three-point shot coming out of that timeout there with the three-point lead.
If it ain't broke, then don't fix it. Powell will be at the line for two. Excuse me, one in the bonus.
Many of the fans beginning to pour out. Still 41 seconds left, and that's a big free throw right there because now it's a three-possession ball game.
73-66, 41 and a half ticks to go. Ball State's turnovers really killed them today. They've recorded 15 turnovers. There's Powell for his second free throw, no good. Lonnie comes off of the rebound. They're going to have to score, and they're going to have to score quick. Cedric takes it in. They can't even get a shot off. Patrick with a wild one. Under to Josh.
Oh, give it out on the ball.
Josh hits a layup. They call timeout.
Murray put the two in. Not sure exactly what Jackson was doing. If you're going to take a desperation shot like that, at least have it be a three-point attempt. But Josh able to stick with it and cut the lead down to five.
Five-point lead with 26 seconds. It's bleak, but not impossible. We got good shooters out there.
So Ball State turned it over nine times in the first half, protected the ball much better in the second half until the closing minutes. Two key turnovers when the Cardinals were just down a couple of points.
Like we said at the top of the telecast, Western Michigan is 1-12, but they're no slouch, and they came to play today. Josh Murray, Cedric Moody, Billy Lynch, Theron Smith, and Patrick Jackson on for the Cardinals.
Last year against Eastern Michigan, remember, similar situation. Down toward the end of the game, Jackson misses the free throw. Moody pulls it out. Desperation bank shot to send the game into overtime.
Ball knocked away by Ball State, though, had to foul. Wasted a lot of time there.
Of course, that was a triple overtime loss to Eastern Michigan. One of the two home losses last year. Ball State was defeated by Northern Illinois in a game, the worst of the season for the Ball State last year.
This could be the second home loss, home conference loss of the season. They only lost two all year last year here at home. Reynolds will be at the line. His free throw is good. Pushes it back to a two-possession game, 6 points. Ball State had the opportunities to do it today. Got started off slow. They find themselves trailing by 7 points with 20 seconds left.
Nice penetrating kick by Moody.
Patrick Jackson misses. Rob Robbins is checked into the game. Good play by Rob to knock it out of bounds. It's going to be a little too late, though. Ball State will fall to 6-6. 1-2 in the Mid-American Conference. Western will improve to 2-12. 2-3 in the Mid-American Conference. Nice pass by Patrick to Josh. And Coach Buckley wants a quick timeout. With 9 seconds and a 5-point lead, Western's pretty confident right now.
So it's back to a 5-point ball game. This will still be 1-1 in the bonus with this foul by Ball State. It'll just be their 19th foul, or actually this will be their 10th. So then Western will be in the two-shot bonus.
9 seconds to play at Worthen Arena. Our first telecast of the season here on Channel 43, WCRH. Reed Rook alongside Todd Bella. Justin Herber's been helping us out on the sidelines.
The Cardinal faithful, the students, seeing their first game here at home in a while. They haven't had too much to cheer about, but they're not leaving yet. Ball State not out of it yet. Still 10 seconds to play. Ball State needs a miracle, but stranger things have happened.
Anything can happen. It usually does. Western gets away, and that's going to be it, folks. No, it's not. They catch up to him and foul him with three ticks left.
T. Smith tried to get Powell way back in the backcourt right when they inbounded it to him. Kind of nudged at the arm, but didn't get him good enough for a foul. And that allowed 6 more seconds to come off the clock. So now 3 seconds virtually over for the Cardinals.
Here's Barry at the line. Had a solid day. 9 points, 3 of 4 from the field. He's hit a three. And the three he hit was really the backbreaker for the Cardinals. Just a freshman, playing well. He Western misses the first.
Western sends everybody back on the defensive end. Clock will not start until the ball is touched following the missed free throw, just like it won't until the ball is inbounded if Barry hits this.
Barry's second free throw attempt is good. 6-point lead, 3 seconds left. Quick pass up to Theron Smith. He pulls up for three, no good, and that's the end of the game. Final score here at Worthen Arena. Ball State loses a heartbreaker, 76-70. We'll be back with post-game. You're listening to Ball State Men's Basketball on WCRH.
Central Indiana, there is only one place to turn for local news.
It's left 2 million Serbian residents.
Ball State has gained national
news
attention.
News Center 43.
America's
and Rule 7.
We're okay on time now, guys.
Clouds begin to form.
Muncie's only live TV newscast.
Reporting live only live on Saturday as we go to the highlight.
An official CNN Student Bureau. News Center 43, Monday through Thursday at 5:30 and 9:30 on Burr's Channel 43.
Okay, class, tomorrow night's college night. Think about your needs.
I need to be challenged.
I need to be my own boss. I need to be his boss, too.
Ball State University, everything you need.
Yes, I am here with Coach Buckley. Coach, what was the difference in tonight's game?
Western Michigan outplayed us. They played a lot harder. They executed their stuff very well. They made some big shots. And those are the things you have to do when you're on the road to win, and they did all those.
And what are you going to tell the guys after a loss like this to keep them motivated?
Well, we need to reevaluate some things and need to find out what direction we're going to go. And it's going to take a little bit of time. I need to reflect and think about some things and watch the tape, and we're just going to have to do some things differently.
Okay, thanks, Coach Buckley. Good luck the rest of the season. So back to you guys in a moment. This is Western Michigan's first win here at Worthen Arena. Back to you guys.
Ball State loses a heartbreaker, 76-70. Here at Worthen Arena, they fall to 6-6. 1-2 in the Mid-American Conference play, and Todd, they were shooting three-pointers, lights out today.
And we're going to take a break and come back with the statistics to show you just how well they shot here on WCRH Sports.
Ball State Sports Online. Schedule, result, headline, features, statistics, game note, team pages, video and audio clip, biography, email, Ball State Link, daily updates. Your only online source for all the latest in Ball State sports. www.bsu.edu/sports.
Western Michigan 76-70 here at Worthen Arena. They fall to 1-2 in the Mid-American Conference. Western Michigan improves to 2-12, 2-3 in the Mid-American Conference.
The Broncos hit 12 long-range bombs in 29 attempts. They were shooting all over the place from beyond the arc. That was the key factor, particularly two big shots down the stretch. Steve Reynolds hits a big three, and then the big one was by Barry. Ball State falls 76-70 in a heartbreaking loss at home. It's early on in the Mid-American Conference, Reed, but these home losses will kill you.
Anytime you lose at home in the Mid-American Conference, it just hurts you a little bit more because you always have to go on the road and play in those controversial places.
Ball State will get another shot at Western Michigan up at, or in Kalamazoo, I should say. And that game is February 24th. Taking a look at the game statistics, the Cardinals shot 40% from the field. They should come in shooting 45% from the field, so below their average in that. Western 42.5%, just under 43% free throw percentage. The Broncos 16 out of 18. Couple of crucial free throws down the stretch. Ball State just 8 out of 16, could not capitalize in that department. The three-point field goal percentage, to give you a look at the numbers here, Ball State 8 of 23, Western Michigan 12 of 29. The turnovers, we talked about the Cardinals needing to protect the ball better in the second half. They did, except for a couple of key possessions. Western turned it over 9 times. The Cardinals, an onslaught of rebounds, winning that 49 to 28 in the rebounding department, but it wasn't enough. Ball State falls 76 to 70 at home to Western Michigan.
Today's leading scorer for the Cardinals was T. Smith. He had 22 points and 13 rebounds. Another solid performance from Theron. Lonnie Jones came off the bench having a double-double, 13 points and 10 rebounds. Cedric Moody had 8 points and 7 rebounds. Patrick Jackson was the other Ball State player in double figures with 10 points. He added 7 assists and 4 rebounds.
I thought it was Lonnie's best game of the season. To get back in the double-double column, we should expect to see from him. Moody, on the other hand, was quiet, just 3 of 9 from the field. Didn't get the open looks he's been accustomed to. Did do a nice job contributing 7 boards, though.
Billy Lynch, 5 points, 5 assists. Robbie Owens started, had 2 points. Robbie didn't play in the second half. And that was all the scoring for Ball State. For Western Michigan, Powell led the way with 23 points. He had 4 three-pointers. Reynolds, a good game, 13 points. 10 points for Barry, 7 for Carter. Taylor Bro had 2, and Cotton came off the bench for 4 points.
And then 13 points for Reynolds all in the second half. Well, Ball State falls 76 to 70. Will it hurt the Cardinals in the Mid-American Conference? We hope not. We'll be back in action on Monday against Northern Illinois when we look to rebound from this loss.
For Reed Druck and Todd Bella. For Todd Bella and Justin Herber, I'm Reed Druck saying good night. You've been watching Ball State men's basketball on WCRH.